So today I'm going to show you a really cool technique. So you're going to need some ink, and you can use any ink you want for this. I'm using distress inks, and then you're going to need some salt. This is sea salt, but you can also use finer table salt if that's what you choose to do. I have a piece of watercolored paper here. So let's get started. I'm using tumbled glass, broken china, and peacock feathers. Okay, so that's not going as dark as I want it to go, so I'm going to just take my peacock feathers here to give it the saturated color that I want. And if you don't like to get your fingers dirty, you can do something else to hold it down. Okay, so this is the fun part. You're going to soak this really, really well with water, like puddled water. Then you're going to take salt here. This is really coarse. And you are going to place it all over your paper. You can do as little or as much as you would like. It's really up to you. I like the sea salt because it is bigger, and I like the effect it gives better than the table salt. But it's completely up to you. So we're going to let this dry, and this is going to have to dry completely on its own, not using a heat tool. If you use a heat tool, this technique does not work. So let it dry completely on its own. I think it'll take at least overnight. It might even take longer, but we will come back and see. Okay, it's the next morning, and I let this dry. So now I'm just going to take my thumb and rub it over the salt crystals. And I would suggest just doing it into a garbage, but since I'm trying to do it on camera, I'm just doing it like this. Okay, so if you don't have many salt crystals, you can always keep these and do it again and again on a project until they're gone. Okay, so that is what it looks like. Isn't that cool? I totally love this technique. And if you were to blow dry it, this gets all cloudy and it doesn't give it the same effect. You can use it with a bunch of different colors. Like I think I might do a tie-dyed one, which I think would be so awesome. So when I do that, I'll show you guys how I do that. And then there is, I don't know if you can see it, but when you twist it, there's like a little bit of, it almost looks like there's little pieces of glass embedded in the cardstock, and that's just from the salt. So it's really cool. It's like glittery glass. Okay, so this is dried for a day and a half. So as you can see, it's just the exact same as the other one where the you just pull off the salt. There are a few differences. I'm going to do this in the garbage really quick and then come back and show you. Okay, so I'm going to show you the differences. This one is using the distress inks, which I'm going to say this is my favorite. If I were to use different colors, you know, obviously it'll turn out a little bit different. So I like the variation, and I like how it embedded a little bit of the salt into it, which is awesome. Also, I think the paper has a lot to do with this. This is watercolor paper instead of just plain cardstock, which I would highly recommend using if you want to get this really variegated, funky, like crystally look. If you don't want to get that look and you're okay with like more of a subtle look, then just use regular cardstock. Okay, so this again is distress inks. This one here is Hero Arts. Hero Arts, yeah. Oops, let's see what it is. Yeah, Hero Arts, the Shadow Inks. And this also had a really cool effect. I think I'll use this one for something like Under the Sea. Because it has a lot of like blues and greens in it, which I really liked. I thought it was pretty cool. And then this is Hero Arts, the Neon Blue. And it obviously just has blue tones in it, so it doesn't have any green in it, which is really cool also for a light snow scene or a summertime scene. And then this one's my second favorite. This is Stampin' Up. And I really love how it turned out with like the dark blues and the light blues and the kind of grays. This was the Midnight Muse I used for this one. And this is going to be a really cool, like dark Christmas scene card I probably will make with this one. So I hope you guys like this technique and will give it a try. I will be posting a video on what I use for this technique, like what I make with it, with these papers. And you can check that out later. So thanks for watching. I hope you will go and create something that's perfectly imperfect. Bye.